came when I was in New Mexico. I lived in Gallup, New Mexico.
How old were you?
Seven, eight, something like that. If I'm on stage, even my idol, my biggest idol on stage, I think, and not even on stage, the biggest idol going off through my head all the time is Charlie Chaplin. Yeah. And, it takes a while to explain it, but I mean, he's one of the men.
Yeah.
And,
when did you first see Chaplin?
I seen a little bit Charlie Chaplin film.
Oh, I don't know.
I just sort of knew who he was and that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Bob Dylan type thing.
Yeah.
Little Roger. And I never really met anything. I never came across anything that could change my mind about this. I never went across any big. I never lived in a big city until I lived in New York.
Me too.
And I don't think it's gotten the best of me. At least I know it hasn't gotten the better part of me. I don't think it touched me. It might have touched me a little bit. In fact, it has touched me a little bit. But I've never lived in a city that was more than 15,000 people. And just all the other distance over here. And I was very stupid at the time. And I was with a friend of mine, and I played. And they flipped. And I figured, oh, you can't see a wall. And I didn't know anything, and they started hooting at me and that kind of stuff. And I asked the guy to give me some money to play. And he looked at me and he said he would. He said, give me a dollar. So he gave me a dollar to play the hooting at me. And, no, in fact, it was $1.50. Anyway, I played there and they flipped. They really did. So I figured as long as they liked me so much, that maybe one of them had a place to stay or somebody could stay that night. So I asked from the stage. And about four hands went up. So my buddy and I sort of went and checked out the mall, picked out the fella, which was a girl right here. And my buddy said to me, you don't look so hot. And I don't think we're, you don't look so hot. Looks like, but he looks pretty gay. And I said, I didn't know anything about the sex game. I said, well, he looks okay. Anyway, he's with a girl. So we went up with him, and the girl got off on 34th Street, mm-hmm. and we got off on 42nd Street. we went in a bar first before we did the final place to stay, and we met his friend Dora. Dora was his friend, stayed with him, and both of us looked, and we ran out of the bar, I ran that place, thank you. That was the first night in New York. I sensed they're liking me. Maybe not the music so much. Maybe if they don't, maybe they even like the music, but I feel like if they saw me on the street, or playing someplace, I feel like they wouldn't be so friendly. I like the land, but the people are strange in the West. I like tons of people. Don't like common people. Hard, which I never could see. Very hard people. And down south, it's worse than that. I can't stand city people from the south. I just can't stand anywhere they're thinking.
Yes, you got
a folk thing. I just think a certain way, that's all. And,
is Woody a folk singer?
Woody was a folk singer. Woody was a folk singer.
Why do you say you're not?
Woody was a folk singer, to the point. Woody was a glorified folk singer. Woody was a man that went back, don't print this on a record.
No,
but Woody was a man who dwelled on simpleness because he was getting attention for it. I played piano. I used to play piano. I used to play great, great piano. Very great. I used to play a piano like Little Richard style. When I used to play, you know, an octave higher. And everything came out. And he had a big mistake. His records were great records, but they could have been greater records. His mistake was he played down too low. He played high. Everything would have compensated. You heard Little Richard?
No.
I don't know. Little Richard did something else. He's a preacher now. But played piano sort of in his style. And I played everything high and amplified.